Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate, Siege of Dragonspear, Blind. We're returning back to the camp to get some rest, get our spells replenished. We still have this to finish exploring the map here. The bridge is out. Recently. And we've recently added McKinn, the Goblin Shaman, to the party. Or Shaman, rather. I've heard it pronounced both ways, but I'm not sure if Shaman is actually correct. So, returning to camp for now.
Yes.
Not going on to the Boroskir Bridge yet because we have more to explore. I keep finding these Menhir stones. We successfully interacted with this one and this one. This one didn't work out so well, and neither did this one. We cannot interact with either of these two at this point. There's five of them? Six. Alright. So two more to find. Maybe if we activate the other two, we'll be able to interact with this one. Here's Edwin, we were forced to kill, because he was wanted to attack Dinah here. We just need a rest, really. So where's our friend? So Corwin no longer accompanies us.
You all right? Sounded like thunder coming from the crossing. I was about to send troops out looking for you.
Kalar's people destroyed the bridge. Crossing is now a wall. We'll have to use Boroskir Bridge to get across the winding water.
Damn it! How could you let this happen?
Let this happen? Well, forgive me, sir. If I had your gift for soothsaying, this tragedy might have been avoided. But alas, I am forced to deal with things as they occur, not before.
Thy words could wield flowers.
At this point, they probably would.
No, they couldn't. That's stupid. You don't know how flowers work, or words.
It's not meant to be taken literally.
We need to get to Bridgefort. Corporal, spread the word to the troops to strike camp. Make sure to mark our new path on everyone's maps. We move out as soon as our friend is ready.
I'm not ready yet.
Yes, Captain.
Head to Boroskir Bridge when you're ready. If you need to get anything done around here, now would be the time to do it. I doubt we'll be back this way anytime soon.
You are welcome here.
We'll have to reroute to Boroskir Bridge. Ophyllis says, "Ho there! Oh, thank the gods, I thought I'd never catch up to you." Oh, I've forgotten who Ophyllis is. Someone we ran into Baldur's Gate. Oh, he's the one who took the money? What are you doing here? Making good on my debt to you. You have my gold? Well, I'm trying to make good on my debt to you. I have some gold. Not all that I owe you. Not yet. But I will get it, I swear. Little bit counts. How did you come into possession of this gold? Nothing too nefarious, I hope, though not enough to care if nefariousness was indeed involved. I guess that I'm not enough to care? Well, as I say, I put the word out I was looking for gold, and a fairly large quantity of it, and actual coins are hard to come by for obvious reasons, but an artisan by the name of Foxley was willing to offer me this. This. Oh. It is a bust of her? And what is this precisely? A gold bust of you. Nice, eh? Foxley's made a small fortune selling them to merchants and nobles put out by the Iron Throne. Between you and me, those have more than a little brass and copper mixed in, but this one, pure gold, and it's yours. Debt's not repaid. What in the night hells am I supposed to do with a gold bust of myself? Well, it's gold, right? And I lost a fair amount of your gold, so I thought this would, you know, go some way towards making up for that. I'm not inclined to be too nice to him. I mean, he stole my gold and gambled with it. So, yeah, no, not debt paid, my friend. This should cover the interest on your debt. Now get out of my sight and don't return to it, meaning my sight, I guess, until you've got my fortune in a form more useful than this wretched hunk of metal. You seem upset. Are you upset? I thought this, well, I know it's not ideal, but it is gold after all, and I'm going now. I'll just go. By the time you return to Baldur's Gate, I'll have your money, I swear. I promise. Farewell. Yes. So there's that. That's that. We'll have to reroute the Boroskir's bridge. With the bridge blown, the Flaming Fist will have to take the long road to Dragonspear Castle. Our new route takes us through Bridgefort, a fort on one end of Boroskir Bridge, the place where Baal died. Is it chance that takes me on this path, or destiny? I missed fortune. I should watch for Ophyllis in case he tries to repay me again. Ophyllis, one of the treasures at the Ducal Palace in Baldur's Gate, is determined to repay me for the gold of mine he lost. To that end, he's given me a bust of my own head cast in gold. He's trying, I have to give him that. Yeah, it's still not enough. Plus, it's a bust of me. Kind of tempted to hold on to it. It will take a little time for the Flaming Fist to break camp and to scout the best route for the army to march to Bridgefort. I'm free to finish up any tasks I have left and to start out for Bridgefort on my own. I'll meet the Flaming Fist there. These people have anything new to say?
Order is what matters.
I thought I'd have a drink at Coast Way Inn tonight, but it's burned down. Gods, why is my life so difficult? Really? You're not the proprietor of the place. Consider yourself lucky.
We're more than mercenaries.
Seen that?
We're more than mercenaries.
Seen that?
We're more than mercenaries.
I've seen that. Corwin?
What do you need?
Oh, can we bring you? Join me, okay. For the moment, nothing? If that changes, you know where to find me, huh? I wonder, who would we replace? McKinn? I'm not sure. Alright. Well, there's a glint.
Yes, that should do it. What? Oh! I didn't see you there. Well, I did. Obviously I did. I'm talking to you. I must have. But it took me a while. Sorry. What were we talking about?
I really can't remember. Couldn't have been that important then. Still, if you should recall the thrust of the conversation, be a dear and remind me, will you? Thanks. Now, these people wait here. Or at least he waits here. But if we move to Boroskir Bridge and all that, do the other people move with them? Will Glint come with them? I guess he would.
This and that to be done. No time to stay and chatter.
There's nothing new here. Didn't sell anything. These scouts weren't here before, were they?
Order is what matters.
Well met. I'm glad to have the hero of Baldur's Gate on our side.
We're more than mercenaries.
I can't wait to meet this so-called crusade. We're gonna give them an unholy hiding. You'll spank them, you will.
Good day, and hello to you.
Let's see if they have anything new to say.
Order is what matters.
We're more than mercenaries.
Order is what matters.
The Coastway Bridge is to the northeast. Wolves and goblins spotted in the western woods. Refugees near a burnout in up the path. Okay. Northeast. Well, that's the bridge that's out. So, those are old reports. You should update them accordingly. Thank you. I just want to see if this guy sells raised dead scrolls.
I have many fine wares.
I'm beginning to really rely on them. And now we have more money, so we can buy some. Wish we had a little search box we could type in. That'd be helpful. Monster summoning 3. Level 5 spell. I don't see you, Rez Dad. What's just cure critical? Give back. 27 points of damage. Huh. It's not even a percentage chance, it's just a flat 27. Alright, let's get some rest. Oh, what does this guy have to say? Anything new?
Yes, that should do it.
What? Oh!
Wrong guy.
I didn't see you there. Well, I did. Obviously I did. I'm talking to you. I must have. But it took me a while. Sorry. What were we talking about?
I thought that was the dwarf that Viconia was with. So I'm not sure where that guy went.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
And I need rest. Okay, good. It's 8 a.m. That's perfect.
Yes.
Alright, let's explore what's to the east. We have found... We need two more menhir stones we need to find. I assume they're in this area. Oh, is this wolves attacking deer?
You want boo?
What's he using?
What?
Watch out! Suffer the wrath of the arcane!
I know, who are we to interfere with the ways of nature,
die.
But...
Die!
Die! McKin saying die. No gratitude from the deer, huh?
Sword first!
What is this? Wait a second. What is that? The deer ran back. Nothing to say. What a shame. This looks almost like a quicksand area. And what is this? Oh, maybe just some kindling or something? Oh, that was interesting. There's a brown bear. We won't bother it unless it bothers us. There might be nothing much down here. There's another brown bear. I thought this was another one of those menhir stones. Gargantuan spider.
What?
They called. Victory shall be ours!
Also a sword spider. Yeah, those things are so quick.
Huh?
Zahar!
I'm doing just fine so far. Okay, now we're getting hurt.
Yes, Abel. Fair enough.
Things after her.
I am yours to command.
I am.
Yep.
Trouble?
This is the end for you. Velvon?
Okay, so I got cure medium. Okay. Got a lot of healing. Not high level healing, but healing nonetheless. F6. I can't seem to put that there. Hold up, maybe...
What?
I have to click it like... No, I got it. Alright. She's only down 4 points. Well done, group.
Yes.
Yes.
Let's talk more fight.
Oh. Hate that. There's another one of those stones.
You want boo?
You can move out of here.
What? Sword first!
Fair enough. What fair enough?
Yes, a simple matter. What fine?
Do it. All right.
Stuck.
Trouble.
No, not now. Maybe once we sink to this stone there will be.
There is no roof to
what?
This world.
Such menial tasks.
Runes eroded by time mark one face of this tall stone menhir. An image shows a winding river. On one bank stands a robed figure clutching a woman to his chest. She looks across the river at a second man who kneels on the bank clutching his throat. Huh. Sing at it? That's never good news. The man hears hum, turns to a hideous crackling sound. Alright, taking 5 electricity damage.
Huh? Yes!
Sing to them until they emit a pleasing tone. I've activated 3. The man here emits a pleasant tone, and its runes glow faintly. It seems to have been activated. Okay. So now we've activated 4.
Trouble sword first!
Hopefully we can activate the others. There's a clearing. Where there's clearings, there's usually trouble. Oh, zombies. Who's that? Daran Highhammer.
A wizard's might!
Devils take your hides, he says. Well, that was easy. Oh, this is an entrance to something. Daran says, "That's some nice verminating you did there, stranger. Pity you didn't come along sooner. Well, it's a pity for those back in the dig. I'm not about to complain. Daran of the clan Highhammer, that's me, slayer of vermin, particularly the two-legged kind, if you know what I mean."
I know what you mean.
You keep a goblin as a pet? Ah, well, I'm happy to work with them that work with me. Morden's hammer, we've got a giant in the dig. Samal, his name is. Good enough fellow, not terribly bright. The Talon said a mountain fell on him when he was a babe. Killed his parents, would have killed him if a kind-hearted dwarf hadn't saved him. Anyway, I realize I might not look much for vermin slaying right now, but look, I was brought on board this project with the understanding that I'd be dealing with, you know, creepy crawlies and such. Onkegs, carrion crawlers, maybe a serpent or two. Undead weren't part of the deal. Didn't bring the fools for taking care of that sort of thing. Oh, the tools, sorry, not fools. I'm Sapphire, just come from Baldur's Gate. Good to meet you. Very good, considering the circumstances. How did you come to be here? I know of no dwarf settlements in the area. You go where the work is, you know. I've up and down the Sword Coast, 15 times in my life, cleaning out nests from Kalimshan to the spine of the world. Never faced anything like it did in this dig. It was a straightforward contract, or so I thought. I was to help with a remote dig organized by a Talond of Dumathoin. If his clerics met anything unpleasant in the tunnels, I'd take care of it. Done dozens, hundreds of these sort of things before, without much trouble. A bugbear nest once. That was about the worst I ever had to deal with, and dealing with it, not so bad compared to what happened in this dig. I'm guessing that's the dig. Where exactly is this dig you speak of? See that cavern there? The clerics, And Cold Hearth, too, they were. You know that thing? Adamant? They were adamant. No one who happened along see anything suspicious, especially if that no one served what's-her-name, Kalar. They were so worried about someone coming along outside, should have been more concerned about what they'd find inside. What exactly happened in there? The clerics were digging down fifth, sixth tunnel they started, looking for whatever it was Deepvein was looking for. Some kind of metal he had a vision about. Vision, feh. He was probably just in his cups. But Cold Hearth came along. He doesn't strike me as the sort to waste time on flights of fancy. Anyway, they dug down and they hit something. It weren't some vein of ore, either. It was full of them things you helped me with and more besides. Cold Hearth went down first. Couldn't turn undead the way the clerics could. Not that it helped them long. Two blinks of a deaf man's eye, and half the order was gone. Me and the others fell back. I told them to leave it and come out. But Auckland Deepvein, he wasn't going anywhere. Not if it meant letting those beasties loose on the surface. He couldn't help it, though. Couple got out. You saw me fighting them. There's more where they came from. As soon as I get my strength back, I'll be going in, seeing if anyone's still alive. If not, I'll, look for a way to make this mess worth my while, if you know what I mean. That's kind of not fair to say. I mean, he was going to see if anyone's still alive, and if not, look for a way to make it worth his while. So yeah, I know what you mean. If any of the priests survive, maybe they have something to offer. If not, Cold Hearth had a chest he kept close eye on. He was first to fall. Doubt he'd mind me taking it as payment for my troubles. Of course, if someone else wanted to go in there and try for the chest while I recover, I could still be convinced to split the take with him. I'm more tempted to say this now. Yeah, there may be people still alive in there, and all you can think of is gold. Nah, I'm also interested in gems and items of value. And if any of them are still alive, I'll do what I can, of course. I'm not making any apologies for doing what I got to. It's a hard world. Gotta be a hard man to live in it. Now, if you'll give me some time, I need to rest. Build me strength back up. Axes high, friend. I should enter the dig site if I want to learn what happened to the dwarves. Near Coastway Crossing, I encountered a dwarven warrior fighting a pair of zombies. He told me that he is part of the dig, or a dig, that somehow came upon a nest of undead. If I enter the dig site, I might learn what happened there. Indeed. I wonder if he has anything else to say.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
You're back. Good. I heard some screams coming from the dig. I think some of the clerics may still be alive. If they are, I'll find them and do everything in my power to keep them that way. Yeah, you do that. I'd come with you had I the strength. Watch your back in there, and keep your axe high. Luck to you. All right, let's go check it out, I guess. The longer we wait, the more dead people there'll be.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Okay, a mummy just got killed.
Sword first!
I don't suppose there are traps, because there are people walking back and forth through here, right? Who's this? Brother Deepvein. He's drawing upon holy might, cast aid on himself. There's a zombie attacking. There's a dwarven cleric. Zombies. And ghouls. Alright, let's have at them.
Yes?
And a white.
I'm coming for you!
There's too many of them. We haven't the power to stop them. Hold them back. Well, they killed one. Is a flame dance ring.
Is as brawny as the gum. He cannot get it. everything, and he must make room for Boo.
Oh, you're full, really?
You want Boo?
Oh, crap, yeah. I have to look at this boss, too. I forgot about that. Container's full. This is the potion, right? Well, it's a scroll case. Scroll of Blur and a Flame Dance Ring.
What?
Mind your box! They're behind us now, too!
Are they? No, 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 you'd mean us? Sapphire is not completely comfortable in bragging that she's the hero of Baldur's Gate. Stay your hand, my sword is sheathed. I am no enemy of yours. Actually, our swords are out, but we're attacking your foes.
Unsheathe your sword. Boo's nose, it twitches. There is evil here.
Unsheathe my sword. If you be a woman of good will and faith, stand with us against this tide of darkness. We're not attacking him. Okay, the white's dead. An amulet of the Keeper of Secrets under the mountain. We'll look at that after. I should help the dwarves fight off the undead if I want to learn what's happening here. Inside a dwarven dig site hidden from the outside, I've stumbled upon what appear to be a group of dwarven clerics in battle with a horde of undead creatures. Indeed.
Go for the ice pool! Go for the ice!
Death comes swiftly!
Aye?
Life is mine!
Oh, thanks! He blessed us all. I think he did. Yeah. Oh, he blessed Minsk, Viconia, and Safana.
Speak.
Does she have...
You have my thanks, stranger. Deepvein's my name. Brother Auckland Deepvein of the Talhoun Order, or Dumathoin's Secret Gleam. What's left of it? No, I shouldn't have complained. We'd none of us have survived that onslaught without your aid.
Excellent accent. Brother Auckland Deepvein of the Talon Order of Dumathoin's Secret Gleam. Right. You might have added a few more adjectives in there, but okay. I met another of your number, a Daran Highhammer, outside the cavern. Gurn Coldhearth falls and that coward lives? Where's the justice in that, I ask you? He was supposed to keep the beasties away from us. That was his job. Ah, well, we'll see. You see him again. Tell him to get his biscuit arse in here and help us. Tell me of this Coldhearth. By the grace of Dumathoin and the gold of me friend, Gurn Coldhearth. Ah, Gurn, forgive me. He believed in me. When I told him the Keeper had sent a vision of a vein of ore running through the ground. Through this ground, one I could forge into chains to bind me to a great Dumathoin for all time. He didn't hesitate. He pulled his chest out and he said, "How much do you need to find it, Auckland?" Dumathoin is a god of the dwarves, or one of them. Dumathoin, who is that? What's so great about him, her, or it? Dumathoin is guardian of the dead, the dark power we disturbed below. Did not care about that. We tumbled and tunneled, and eventually we hit something. But it weren't no ore. It was a room full of books. Books and the monsters you saw us fighting. Books, you say? I should like to see these books. And I'd like to see my friend Gurn Coldhearth again, but there's a sea of living, death, twixt us and that which we seek. Well, if they're anything like this, they're simple. I'm sure they get harder. Me fellows and I need time to rest, to heal. Once that's done, we'll venture back into the caverns, slay the slain one final time, and find Gurn's body. I'll not return to the hole without it. Stay here and ensure no other undead escape. I'll venture into the caverns and find your friend. I wish we were in any kind of shape to help you out, but we're not. Watch your back in there. I should seek out Coldhearth's remains for the dwarves. The dwarves I encountered are indeed clerics. Their leader, Auckland Deepvein, told me a vision brought them here in search of a holy ore. Instead, they found a mass of undead. I have promised to retrieve the remains of Deepvein's friend Gurn Coldhearth, that they may be returned home. Okay. Well, before anything else, you know, yeah, I'll take that. And that. And this. Well, a gold bust. This is a garish likeness of your own head, cast in pure gold. You do not feel it is accurate and doubt anyone would be able to recognize your visage. Okay. An amulet of the Keeper of Secrets under the mountain. Upon first examination, this simple talisman appears to be forged of iron. Closer inspection reveals that the iron is a thin shell concealing more valuable materials within. The links of the chain are gold, while a hidden latch on the charm itself flips it open, revealing a sparkling emerald set inside. Huh. That's just use for selling? I can go in there. I forgot to sell those bolts and some of the other things. Well, we got this whole dungeon ahead of us. Dwarven clerics. Oh, I guess you can stop turning undead now. I'm gonna call in an episode here, and then we'll talk to these guys and explore this dungeon. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.